So the last step of this lab will be on multi-language. So we will add a new language to our application. So the first thing we will add is a flex button with text. This one will show, which shows alt, in fact, for alternate, because we will not switch to Italian or German. We will stick to English, but with different namings. Then we will assign a language interaction button to button. So when we click this button, we will call a specific C++ code to update the language. And for that, we have to also add a new language to the application. So on screen one, so back to the designer, you can see that I still got all everything open because it's not an issue to keep CubeMX and CubeID open while editing only the graphical user interface. In the screen one, so now we add a flex button and name it to button toggle language. And the location, I will set it just after. So as for the next button, we will add a style image so that we can remove the default style and set the image press the release state and press state, and then add also a text style, and the text will be alt for alternate, and I will set it to white like this. So now I have to set the text at the proper location, and in the image style I must stick lock the flex button to the image size so that it is displayed correctly. So now I can see that I didn't use the slide set position for my buttons, so it's not an issue. I can move them like this, and the alt is too far now, the text is too far. Like this. Okay, so now it's okay for the button. I can, yes, I forgot to change the color of the text. Oh no, it's okay, it's white when it's released, then black when it's pressed. And then I have to add, I will add an interaction again from the designer. So the interaction will be button toggle language. It will be triggered by the click of the button, the one we just added, and the action will be to execute some C++ code that we will enable in a few seconds. So this has to be done as soon as you support multi-language. Yes, you have to handle the changing of the multi-language, the update of the language, in fact, in the source code. There is no real, there is no yet not yet an interaction that can automatically change the language. It's not implemented yet. Maybe it will be in a future version, but for the moment, you have to define a function, toggle language, and in it. We provide how to do it, and it's also provided in the TGFX documentation to change the current language. So now we have to add this new language. So we are going to the text panel. So by the way, I will remove this typography because I do not use it, and it may show something that may be interesting for you, because it is possible that doing that I will get an error message, because there is a known issue at this time regarding the update of the CubeID project by the TGFX. Sometimes we observed that some files that were removed from the layout We are not removed properly from the CubeID, and we are leading to errors. And in fact, it's just because the CubeID project was not properly updated. And it is not clear at this time if the problem comes from the TouchFX designer. So the Ruby, yeah, there are some Ruby, RUBY, Ruby scripts that are called to update the dot project file of CubeID, or if it comes from the CubeID project itself. So okay, it's under investigation. So it's interesting that I remove this one just to see if there is the error. So this in our typographies, I going to single use and add a new language. So my new language will be Alt. So for alternate. And you can see here that the as soon as something is becomes red in the TouchFX designer, it means that something is it's a warning that will cannot lead to you cannot generate the code properly. You cannot generate the code at all, in fact, if you do not correct this. It can happen also if you remove an image, for example, from this panel, then there will be a warning on the canvas in the canvas view saying that this image is missing. So quickly, the so we have now two languages, and we will set the values for each. So this can be edited also directly in the Excel file that is in the asset folder. And this is interesting when you have several different languages, and the person that are in charge of the translation are not do not want to install the TouchFX designer. They do not have to, in fact, because if you go to the TouchFX asset folder in the text, you have this text, this Excel sheet. I will not open it right now because it is already opened by the designer, so it will be complaining because of the Microsoft lock systems. But this file contains all the translation of all the text that is in the layout. So if you just transfer this file and say to your colleague, okay, just put the translation, the Italian translation or Spanish translation at this disposition, and then you retrieve the text file. You can then directly update this value without the need of installing the TouchFX designer on the other side. It's quite convenient. So I will put screen 2. Screen 1, etc. So this is the translation from when. Oh no, no, this is the wrong translation. I thought it was the same order. It is not at all. So no problem. Screen length control. So it's the logical one. And board length control is the physical one. So software becomes EMG. Hardware is LED. And junction temperature is internal. That's it. So I have all my translation into a different language. And now I can generate the code corresponding to that. And all the only thing that will remain will be to implement this Tangle language. Of course, you can imagine here we have only one button which toggles between two languages, but you can imagine a drop-down menu that will allow you to select a language from a list. If you have several languages, like five or six languages, you can select them from a drop-down menu and associate the selection of this of one item of the menu with the update of the language. You will see that the Changing the language is only a call to one function and updating the text area that are visible on the current screen. Because on the next screen, the language will be, it is stored in the model because it's the only thing that is constant in the application. So when you change language, you change a value in the model. And if you change the screen, then the model will tell the screen, be careful. You are in this language, so you have to use this translation or the text corresponding to this language. So the generation is done. We will now go back to the CubeIDE project. So in the CubeIDE project, I will do exactly as what I did for the first for the two previous lab. And search for the third define. So in this case, we have only two places where it's updated. The one that sets the current language. So remember what we defined in the designer will not appear in the screen one view bay screen run view the CPP, but in the screen run view base the CPP. So this code will the code we added will be called outside this file, but in the mother class we'll call the presenter toggle language, which is defined here. So in toggle language we first get the current language. So this is from the model. This is independent of the presenter. In fact, this text get language is a function that is available. Is a static one that is available during the application runtime. And we get the current language. We also have access to the number of languages that are available. So this is included in this file. So these include files are also mandatory to manipulate the language. So that is described also in the JFX documentation. And if the current language is the maximum one, in fact, it's a rotary changing of language. If we had put three languages, it would have not only toggled, but changed from the one to two, two to three, three to one, etc., etc. It's a circular, yes, a circular update of the circular toggle, let's say. And so we change the view. We tell the view. So the view tells that the button has been clicked, and the presenter decide to tell the view to set the language to either zero or to the current language plus one. So in the view, this function is called when the button is pressed. We set the current language to the one specified in argument, and we invalidate all the textual element that are visible on the screen. We could avoid that, but in this case, we would see only the change of the language by switching to another screen. And then switching back to the screen will also update the current the textual value. So if we want to update as soon as we click on the button, we have to invalidate all the text areas. So we can if we have only three here, but we can of course create a dedicated function if you have more text areas. And then if you add one more in your application development, you just have to update one function and not each time you update the language. So let's add this step three compilation flag. As well as in the C++ code. Rebuild. And now we will see that pressing the Alt button will change the language automatically. We can even launch directly The Debug Session. It will trigger the make, the build of the project and flash the board. So this is very interesting because I did not respect, it seems, the naming convention. And so when we refresh, invalidate this text stamp field, this field does not exist. And it is just a small mistake from me. The text stamp should be there. Yes, it is text area, which is wrong. So now it should be better. I can build again, hoping that I did not misspell any other widgets. But at least it is still interesting to see that. Okay, there is another one. Ah, this is exactly what I mentioned earlier. The other compilation issue is that the system misses this Verdana font I removed. It is normal. So I have to, so the update of the kubeidi was wrong from the TouchFX designer. This will be fixed. I already reported the issue. So all I have to do is remove this file from here. You see, there is an exclamation point here. So I do not use this one, and I do not need either the associated other files that are missing also. So the kerning is for the. These are files that are generated when handling text and fonts in general to determine the distance between the characters. In fact, the kerning, that's what is the kerning for. And so hopefully. So do not be surprised in the future, in your future development. If this happens, you'd only have to remove the file, and it will mean that you added something, generated the code, and then removed it. And sometimes the removing is not fully functional. But it's only a question of file referenced by the kubeidi project. So in the target, in the designer, it will build and flash properly using the internal makefile based toolchain. And in kubeidi, it will sometimes fail. But for sure, this will be fixed. So now it's okay and can run the debug and finally see the result. And do not worry, in fact, it's just that here it is. It was not started, it was the last image that was displayed before I stopped the camera. So now I can switch the language and it switches in both screens. And you can see that here the name is too long. So this has to be adapted, of course, and this is also a way to tell you that you must take care of the dimension of the text that when you change the language. But anyway, the language is changing as I expect. So that's the end of this lab. What I wanted also to show you. We talked about the build analyzer. So in the build analyzer, there are two points. In fact, here you can see the section and the memory usage in terms of flash that is done by the application. You can see that there is a red red box here. It's not an error, it's just a warning, but it's a known one. It's just telling us that the RAMFB section, so the RAMFB section is defined in this scatter file. Here we defined a RAMFB section, which starts at this address and is 768 kilobytes long. It contains the two frame buffers that we defined for this application. And how are we sure of that is because the frame buffer has a specific pragma location attribute, which is called frame buffer section. So if we go so it's the jfix target and int jfix generated should be here it is. So the tjfx frame buffer is a pragma that we define around the frame buffer array that is defined to contain the frame buffer that the tjfx library will use. And so this specific pragma can be used by the scatter file to position this section at a specific location, which will be. So we can find here the pragma, and it will be put in RAMFB. So it's perfectly normal to see that. And know that the same mechanism is used. I showed you previously in the image panel that each image was attributed a section. So here it's X flash section, and the same principle works. You see that X flash section is defined here and will be put in OctoSPI. So all the input images will be put with this mechanism in OctoSPI. And you can see that this XFlash section pragma location is defined for all the images that have been generated. So this is, for example, the first image of the animation. And you can find back this XFlash section, flash section pragma location directive to associate that will be associated with this this table that contains the input image for the first animation. It's the same for all the input bitmaps. So that this is how we are sure that we are locating at the right in the right external memory or internal memory the input object of our layout. So maybe a last point would be to show you also how the HAL part of the tjfx framework, where it is located. So the HAL part is the first the operating system function, the locking mechanism that are needed by the tjfx library. So these are located in the os wrapper .cpp file. See, if we go back to the CubeMX project in the tjfx plugin, you can see that here we specify in the plugin that the CM6 RTOS FreeRTOS v2 is used. And in this case, this OS wrappers .cpp file will be populated with FreeRTOS calling function. So we can see here that we have some OS semaphore ID, OS message queue ID, and we are using some semaphore function that comes from the FreeRTOS interface that is included, by the way, here. In case you do not want to use FreeRTOS or any RTOS at all, you just have to say it. So to say so here, to say no OS or custom eventually. And in this case, you will have this function mostly empty, and you will have to populate them yourself. And the most important one are the take frame buffer semaphore and the give frame buffer semaphore. These are the locking mechanism when you use the Chromart accelerator to be sure that the Chromart will not edit the frame buffer while it is being displayed by the LTDC controller, for example. The other mechanism is the signal vsync and the wait for vsync. In fact, this wait for synchronization is called by the library each time a new frame buffer is ready to be displayed. And the signal vsync is called in our example, we are using the LTDC, so it is called by the LTDC interrupt handler. when at the end of the full fresh reframe. So 60 times per second, this signal vsync function is called, and that triggers the blanking period of the display. So it's the period between during which the buffer that the display is currently displaying can be modified. Otherwise, it is read by the internal controller of the display, and it should not be modified in order to not to have any artifact on the screen, any flickering and stuff like that. So this we can have a look at the TouchFX HAL function. So the HAL function is the inherited function class from the generated HAL. And this one, since we set the LTDC controller in the Cubemx project, this one is automatically populated with the LTDC interrupt that we can find here. So we have the line event callback, and you can see that the signal vsync is called when we are sure that we are in the last line of the we just updated the last line of the frame, and so we are before the next first line occurs, we have some time to update the frame. So just to say that the OS wrapper.cpp is all the TouchFX library, all the mechanism that it needs to be functional. It does not need an OS, but it needs this kind of mechanism. And this kind of mechanism in other implementation are simulated by a timer interrupt. So there is a volatile variable that is used, that is 0 or 1, and when the library wants to lock to wait for sync, if in fact it waits until this variable is set to 1, and this variable is only set to 1 by an interrupt when the timer interrupt occurs. So this is a much maybe finer, much complicated synchronization mechanism, but it is functional for TouchFX. Last but not least, I wanted also to remind you that we are providing many examples on our ST development kit. But to access them, in fact, you must go to the TouchFX Designer and download the corresponding application template. When you create a new project in TouchFX Designer, you end up into this dialog box, and here you can select the application template and here the UI template. So the application template is by default the simulator, so the PC simulator. You can change it to many of our boards, and depending on the boards, the display is not driven the same way. On a F750 discovery board, it's driven by the LTDC, for example. On other board, it will be driven by the DSI host, and for example, the 769 is a DSI connection. So you have an example of a DSI interface to the display for to base your own work, and it's the same for the for example, if you take the L496 discovery kit, it is connected through SPI. So if you create a project based on this, you select this this application template and create, you take a matching UI. So this one is the right size of the display. And then you click on the create button. It will download the code for this platform. And it will contain an implementation of an SPI connection to a display. That can be used in your specific case. You can use this code to adapt to your own display. And the last, very last point, it is quite important also, is that among all these application templates, you can see that there are versioning. For here, for example, we are in version 3. Version 3, all, most of them are in version 3. Some of them are also in 3.0.1, but some of them are also in version 1. So what does it mean? Only the version 3 supports the Cubemx plugin. So if you take this H747 application template, you will not have associated to it a Cubemx project. The main reason, in fact, is that de TouchFX plugin is based on a Cube Expression Pack, a CMC pack implementation, which is not yet supported for dual core. So it's also the case for L5, while it is not dual core. So there you have to be just aware that only the 3.0.0 version and above will provide you with a CubeMX project that is compatible with the CubeMX 5.5, which means that it supports the Xcube TouchFX expansion pack. So that was it is also mentioned in the documentation, but sometimes it's you do not find information and you are quite you are wondering why your version is not working, why the application template is different. So it is ongoing. In fact, we are currently migrating at the beginning at the first release of the Xcube to JFX. Only three boards were supported in version 3.0.0. Today, you can see that almost all of them are supported. And we are expanding the number of ST development kits also that are supported as an application template. Here we are focusing. We were focusing first on the one that embeds embedded display and also some LTDC, the LTDC component or the Chrome Art component. But we also developed some application templates, some internal ones that are not yet in this list for G0, for example. So it is also using a SPI interface. With on a platform that has absolutely no graphic accelerators, but it's still working because there is some specific implementation within the TouchFX library that allows, for example, not to use a full frame buffer, full image, a full display frame buffer, but only a few lines. In this case, of course, you are limited when you are updating your entire screen. But if you are updating only a part of it, it is as smooth as on a graphic-enabled board. So all these will be covered by short videos on specific topics. But it has to you have to keep in mind that this list of application templates are accessed by the designer from the web, so the list can evolve even on the same version of the TouchFX plugin. You do not have to wait a new version of the TouchFX designer to have a new template application template, and sometimes it is even possible that we provide you with a in advance with an application template that we will put in a specific folder in the TouchFX installation folder, and you will be able to use it even without downloading it from this web server. That's it for this lab. I hope you enjoyed it, and see you soon.